So.
Yeah, both players played really well. I was very impressed with them. It was a very exciting game. All right, guys, we have, this is A-Train. I'm here with Zai and Thudbang. Akira is also on the call, but he might be on mute. He is the one that's controlling the camera for us today. So thank you, Akira, for doing that. And the map is going to be Antiga Shipyard. This is a matchup between IBM and Microsoft. This is game two of the series. We do have the blue player Diophant on the bottom left corner of the map. He is representing IBM, and his opponent is Heresy from Microsoft, the orange Terran. So we will be seeing a Protoss versus Terran on Antiga Shipyard. I looked at the profiles of both players. They are in Master League. I think Diophant, he doesn't play as many 1v1s on the account that is linked to his Master League profile, but he's a very strong player to represent IBM in this match. And his opponent, Heresy, is currently ranked in Master League as well. He was pretty high on the ladder last season. So another matchup of Master League players. Looks like both players have scouted pretty early, in my opinion. Diophant's going out to the 9 pylon. Looks like Heresy also scouting before, or right after its supply depot went out. So it looks like the Terran player got lucky here and got the first location. We'll immediately see where his opponent is. But he's not going to be able to see too much. He does see the one gateway right there.
Pretty is standard. Dio gonna? Yep. Okay. Dio moved his probe to the correct base now. After the Terran scouted him,
he knows that. Well, if he scouted me this early and I scouted the location to the right of me and he's not there, he must be above me. So, smart play by Diophant to go to the right location now.
Terran's getting gas, so we're not gonna see a one rex fast expand.
Yep. We do have gas from the Terran player. I think this is common among Microsoft players. I feel like they play with gas openings a lot more than you might see on the ladder, for example, the gasless expansions. But I think it's very safe and it's not too greedy. And you can still get a very strong economic game even if you do get that gas as a Terran player.
So I don't play in this matchup. What openings are possible off of one gas like this?
Usually it signifies some kind of a tech lab or reactor. It looks like it is going to be a tech lab on the barracks. This will be, you'll have lots of early marauders, or you could end up getting a Reaper as well to do some kind of early harass and scouting. Looks like our Protoss player has gone for one gate. He has a lot of options at this point, but he does have one gas, and that's a signifying factor that he was probably doing a one gate expand.
Terran is not going to your axe, so that is good news. If Dio does decide to one gate expand, early to your axe pressure can be a lot of trouble for the one gate expansion.
Yep. It does look like there is going to be a one rex expand with the tech lab, followed by a Reaper. So the Marauder is out. He should be able to get inside the bunker with the Marine to deny any kind of early pressure for a little bit. But it looks like he's going to go ahead and poke out early with his units. I think this is a good thing for a Terran player to do. There's only in the early game, there's only going to be a Zealot and a Stalker at best.
Dio might see that coming with that Stalker. Yep, Dio sees it coming with that Stalker, so good placement by that.
And then the Reaper probably is going to go ahead and creep up here while this attack is going on.
But did he see it? He's not moving the Stalker back down.
He might not have seen it on the minimap.
Looks like a bunker is being placed at the natural of Diophant. So he's going to have to try and take out these units as best.
Oh, nice. Looking
down the Marauder.
Got crushed.
Position right now. If he can kill that one Marauder, that'll be huge for him. Does get the Marauder kill. No damage to dive in here. Basically a free kill for and an NSCP loss. So great.
And the Reaper went down too. Didn't even get in the base to scout.
Yeah, that's why he left the Stalker there. It was very good.
So, Diophant opened up very strong, going into a three gateway expansion. And it looks like the timing of these expansions for both players will be about the same.
That is a weird proxy pylon. He is definitely hiding some kind of shenanigans here because that's an insane spot for it.
Yeah, we do have a pylon on the very right side of the map. Even if somebody wanted to mine there, it would be blocking the path of the mineral, so he could be hiding some kind of special tech. We'll have to wait and see what he wants to put there.
Uh,
Looks like our Terran player has opened up with three racks. Pretty standard off of this one gas build. The gateways are finished now for Diophant, the blue Protoss player.
Oh, he's just hiding his gateways over there. Not bad. The Terran should never see that. Oh, a lot of gateways. The Terran should never be able to scout over there.
We have five gateways going down at that one spot on the right side, so this looks like it will be some kind of two-base timing attack. Could be very strong as long as it's good micro. There are three bunkers now for the Terran player, so it will be a little bit tough to bust up that ramp.
But he's starting a lot of tech. He's starting his plus one. He's starting second gas. He's still getting... I guess Stim will be finished by the time he gets there. But all the stuff that he's getting that would help the Terran in the late game means it's going to be harder for him to defend this rush.
Does Dio even have the saturation to fund eight gates, though?
Looking at the worker count, 31 workers right now. He is fully saturated at his main base, about halfway saturated at his natural. So over time, he might be able to... this push is very early. Usually you wouldn't expect to see anything until 10 minutes, but looks like his gates are all finished.
Ghost Academy going down too, but that's not going to be relevant in time. I think that was Thud mentioned earlier that the tech does not help Terran because it means he's not getting units.
Yeah, right now we really only have the two barracks and the one with the tech lab, so only able to produce so many units. If these bunkers go down, it'll be very hard for the Terran player to defend this.
Terran's plus one is 30 seconds away. Dio needs to go now. That plus one would be...
The army supply is huge for Dio, and he needs to make sure he uses his Guardian Shield and his Force Fields. Looks like Sim goes down. One bunker goes down. A second one's probably going to go down. I don't know about that. The third one in the back, looks like he needs to continue warping units if he wants
just
to...
He needs to just run by right now. He's not going to be able to kill that.
Either use Force Fields. His Force Fields go down, and he's able to... deny the SUVs from repairing this, but right now losing a lot of units, and I don't know if he'll be able to finish off the Terran right here.
Nope, he just needed the A move there. He could have killed all the SUVs, all the Marines that weren't in bunkers. He needed either run by or just A move and kill all the guys repairing.
Yeah, if we look at the resources lost, 2,600 resources lost for the Terran, for the Protoss player, where only 900 was lost for the Terran. So, very good hold for the Terran player.
That was a really strong timing. He got too focused on that bunker.
Diophant continue to try to keep up the pressure right now, but not going to be able to bust this anytime soon. He might have delayed the next bunkers from going up.
He can still do some damage with a run by. There is only 11 Marines on the map.
The run by at the beginning probably would have been the best put, but he is still he is committed to this timing right now. He is trying to do as much damage. He wants to end this game right now. Again, attacking the bunkers head on.
Now he's focusing some SCVs.
Yeah, he is taking down a lot of SCVs right now. Looking at the worker count, he is ahead in the worker count, 40 to 34 right now.
But with two mills, I think the Terran is actually slightly ahead.
Oh, just run by.
Zealous again, trying to take out these bunkers. But right now, not going to be able to bust this. He needs to go ahead and try and... at least he's continuing to make probes. He does
have
any other kind of tech right now, and as these upgrades continue for the Terran player, he'll get farther behind.
Yeah, the good thing here is that he's keeping up on his probe production, so he is getting further... And the Terran looks like he stopped SCV production for a little bit. So Dio is getting further ahead.
Dio's going to need a robo facility soon, or nukes are actually going to be really good. And Dio's going in again. I don't think Dio realizes he's actually ahead in workers, because he can't bust that wall down.
We do have one nuclear missile ready. A second one has not been armed yet.
There's the robo.
Robo does go down at the natural. There is no third yet for the Protoss player. There's no third for either player.
Yeah, I think Dio thinks he's further behind than it really is. The Terran player cut SCVs for a while and lost a bunch, so...
Well, the lack of an observer really hurts the game sense for Dio. He has no idea what's going on inside the Terran space right now.
I think... Yeah, the Terran already has cloak, so he could actually move out and nuke right now, but I think he thinks Dio is still rushing. Or, I don't know what he's doing.
this robot is going to finish, and he's going to have an observer before the time he can nuke.
We do have a third going down at the base of Diophant, so he does have a lot of probes that he should be able to transfer as soon as that's finished. Still no third for the Terran player.
All right, here comes the drop for nukes. He just loaded up the dropship.
No, observer. Okay, there's the observer coming, but it will probably be out of position.
Oh, he cloaked the ghost in the medevac first. At least he cloaked them first. Does that save energy?
I think he wants them to come out cloaked.
The stalkers are not going to get to that medevac in time. The medevac's not coming, though.
Do they continue using energy when they're in the medevac? I guess
that's
my
question.
Yeah.
So the longer that the medevac stay in there...
Are we going to do it from the...
Oh, he scanned, otherwise he might run right into those stalkers.
Meanwhile, we do have a double forge going down for our Protoss player, so he's going to start getting his upgrades really quick. Still right now, just stuck on gateway units, though.
Observer's right on it. It died, but he knows it's coming.
Come on, Dio. Move your stalkers!
Nope.
Does he have a second observer right now? He does not. Nukes going down everywhere. Two nukes going down on the building.
Oh, just move, Dio.
I think he should be targeting workers. What do you guys think of this nuke right now?
Will that kill all that stuff?
I'm not sure. I don't get to see nukes very often. It does kill all the buildings.
He doesn't really need those gateways, though. He already has five.
He is going to lose the cybernetics core, however. That could slow down
the cybernetics. Yeah, that's annoying.
These two ghosts are going to go down.
I think Dio's, he's fine. Like, he lost his core, but...
He still has five gateways on the right side of the map, yes.
He's got two robos, his forges are still working.
He does have a ton of money he needs to spend, though.
Looking at the worker count, still ahead for the Protoss player, but the army is slowly getting larger for the Terran player. Lots of Marines.
6 to 7 Marines. If he can get 4 or 5 Colossi out...
Yeah, he's right now he has one.
He's only got one Colossi and no range, though.
He does have one sentry as well. We'll definitely need to increase the sentry count when all those Marines move out.
Yeah, this is going to be bad news.
He's starting two more Colossi.
Colossi will not be out in time, and I think he forgot about range, too.
He does not have the range yet. He needs to go ahead and stay in his base. Definitely needs to get some sentries out here, but he lost the cybernetics core, so he can only produce zealots right now. The cybernetics core just finished.
Oh, no range is going to be so brutal.
Looks like he will probably go for the third first. Does he know
he'll
about
have his Colossus in time?
He doesn't know about this third. He could have gone up for the third and at least maybe taken out that the Nexus.
Uh-oh.
Okay, this is unusual. I don't know.
Okay. Stay in the game, please.
This game's still too close right now to drop.
Looks like the medvacs are being loaded, so we should see a drop pretty soon.
Terran's going to drop and attack the front or the third at the same time. If Dio can catch these guys loaded, though...
Go. But he doesn't realize that he doesn't have range.
The stalkers do not have blink. Just like one medevac.
One of those things. These Marines have no medevacs in them.
Yep.
They're just going to have to run away.
Oh, no, he's...
This is a base trade scenario.
Yeah, he is going for the base trade at this point, it appears.
Dio needs to get some probes out and try and take Terran's third base, kill Terran's base, and then defend the third.
Yeah, we do have a base race, guys. Looks like the Marines are going to town on the main. Two more Colossus being produced. I don't know if he'll be able to save them either. We'll end up seeing what happens there.
He's got buildings to protect him. He just needs to fry as many Marines as he can.
Didn't
he kill some?
The problem is Terran can always float their buildings, and right now there are no Stargate units to...
Dio's got to get a probe out. Got to take probes in his third base and get it out of there.
Yeah.
Try and save as many probes. One probe is leaving the base. He does have a lot of money stockpiled, so that's a good thing. He should be able to rebuild pretty quickly.
But he needs a Nexus. He can't just make pylons with that thing.
Viking's taking down these Colossus, but the Colossus are pulling being record back, so that's a good thing. Saving those Colossus is huge. Right now, only one Colossus remains, however.
Yeah, Terran's got a lot of Marines. No more Vikings are going to be out in time. No range. This is not good for the Protoss.
60 Marines, 8 medevacs. The command center floating away for the Terran player to a new location. The same location where Diophant wants to expand to, so this should be very interesting.
Dio needs force fields here.
One Colossus. He's surrounded by his units are getting surrounded right now. He's going to lose the Colossus as well. This is not looking good for our Protoss player.
That was Dio needed to get a force field on that ramp halfway through. He's
a lot of units to this strong Marine army, and every single soccer will go. And there is the GG.
Dang, Dio.